Continuing with the construction of simply connected covering spaces, recall that we made a definition of semi-locally path connected, semi-locally simply connected spaces. Okay. Then we studied the path space over such a space and showed that the evaluation map is continuous there and it's an open mapping also. So this lemma today is a key to what should expect, what we should expect. So where to look for the simply connected covering space for a given X. So X is locally path connected and connected space. Suppose P from X bar to X is a covering projection with X bar path connected. Take a point X naught in X, X naught bar in X bar, such that P of X naught bar comes to X naught. Then the induced map P star from the path space of X bar to path space of X, namely a path omega going to P composite omega. So that is the map induced by P on the path spaces. This itself is a homeomorphism. Now, this lemma is not essential for the proof or for the construction of simply connected covering space. But it tells you where to look for the simply connected covering space. It tells you that it doesn't matter to take the path space, where to take, whichever covering space, you don't have to construct this. Namely, all of them are homeomorphic to the path space of X itself. Therefore, the simply connected covering spaces, covering space, if it exists, must be a quotient of the path space itself, path space of X itself. So this is the lemma which directs you to for that one. So the proof of this lemma, that homeomorphism, is essentially to proving that this P star is also an open mapping, which is somewhat similar to that the evaluation map is open mapping that we have done. So I will presently skip the proof of this one and go towards the construction of a simply connected covering space. If time permits, we can come back to the proof of this one. Okay, at some other stage. Okay, so here is a proof, but I will skip this proof now. The proof has some nice diagram also here and so on. Okay. So, as I told you, we have already proved that the evaluation map from the path space to X is an open mapping. Open. Surjective because X is path connected. Therefore, X itself can be thought of as a quotient space of Px x bar, Px x. Okay. From the above lemma that just now which we skipped, it follows that every covering space of X is also a quotient of Px x. Okay. Why? Px x is homeomorphic to P bar XX and X bar is quotient of PX bar. Therefore, X bar is also quotient of PX. Therefore, let us work out whatever we want to do with PXX itself. Okay, that is the idea. So, here is the final proof. So, we start. Okay, proof of theorem 7.1. Start with a semi-locally simply connected space. I am just repeating these things. take a point x naught belonging to x, okay, that is fixed point, okay, base point, and this capital P, bold P, let it denote Px x naught. Again and again, we don't have to write as a big symbol. That's all. This space is given the compact open topology. Remember that also. We now define an equivalence relation in P by saying that omega is equivalent to gamma. Remember, these are paths starting at x naught. Okay. If and only if these two paths are path homotopic. In other words, omega 0 is already gamma 1, but endpoints must be also the same. And it must be path homotopic, namely endpoints must be fixed during the homotopy. Remember that. That is the equivalence relation. Let X bar be a quotient space of equivalence classes, and let phi from P to X bar be the quotient map. Okay. So what is the difference? The difference is in the definition of fundamental group, we took the loops at a single point. Now we are taking all paths. The endpoints could be, the other endpoint could be anything in the space of inside X. That is the difference. Okay. So this is something much huger than just the set pi 1 of x naught. It is not a group either. This is given a topology now. What is the topology? Topology coming from the compact open topology of the path space. As a quotient of that, this is x bar is the quotient space. Okay. So by definition, these two are path homotopic, means the endpoints must be the same. Therefore, it follows that the evaluation map, remember, is just take the endpoint. Okay. So that factors through the equivalence classes. On the entire equivalence class, it takes the same value. Therefore, the E factors through a map, okay, like this. Okay, this is X bar to P. You get the map from this. This map is what I'm calling it as P now. Remember, we have to construct not only the space, but also the projection map. So this P is nothing but E factored through the quotient. Take any class here, it's represented by any path, the endpoint is independent, and take the endpoint here, so that is the P of that. So P of this is also just the endpoint, but it is independent of the path class. Okay? Yeah? Now, one easy thing here is that P is an open mapping, because we have shown that E is an open mapping. Take an open set, by the very definition of quotient space, inverse image is open. The image of that is the same thing as image under P of the original open set here. So E is open, so P is also open. Okay? We have to show that P is a covering projection. We have to show that X bar is simply connected. Okay? So these two are the tasks now for us. Okay? So, let us start with V, any path-connected open set X, such that the inclusion-induced map on the fundamental group from pi 1 of V to pi 1 of X is trivial. Such an open subset around every point is guaranteed by the hypothesis of semi-locally simply connected. Just for economically some words, let us call such a set as ambiently one connected. It is not simply connected by itself. It need not be. When you pass to the whole space, its fundamental group becomes trivial. That is the meaning of it. Ambiently one connected. Okay. So what we know is that x is covered by open subsets which satisfy this property. They are ambiently connected. Okay, we claim that if V is ambiently unconnected, then V is evenly covered by P. And that will finish the proof that P is a covering projection. Okay, the idea of the claim is clear. All right, so we have to execute this one now. Given a path starting at x naught, there is an element of P such that the endpoint is inside V. V is chosen to be some open set which is ambiently unconnected. We are going to define a set of, you know, subsets of X bar. So what are they? Consider the set V bracket omega, because this is going to depend upon V as well as the class of omega. The class of omega is an element of what? It's an element of X bar. Remember that. Okay. So all such classes, they are also elements of X bar, which are omega star omega prime. Path is which look like omega star omega prime, wherein this omega prime is a small loop, you know, a small path completely contained inside V. Remember, omega to begin with is a path from x naught, x naught to omega 1. Okay, omega 1 is what? Omega 1 is some point of x. All right, then I am taking that this class is an element of x bar. I am extending it by omega star omega prime by some path within V, which starts at omega 1. Look at all those, that is going to be V omega. Okay, the claim is, so I have here a picture here, start with omega like this, which ends inside this open subset V. Then I can extend it by some omega 1 or omega 2 and so on. These extensions are completely inside me. Okay. So this my picture I can keep referring to again and again. So we have defined V omega like this. Okay. Then P inverse of V, V is an open subset, P inverse of V is some open subset, right, of X bar. This is the union of all V omegas. V omega defined that way, whereas omega 1 must be all those paths have to take union over all those paths, so omega 1 must be inside V. Okay, only then omega V omega makes sense, by the way. So you look, all the paths which come inside V at the end point must be inside V, then look at V omega, that will be P inverse of V. Remember, P is nothing but the endpoint, right? The endpoint must be inside V. So if you have the point is already inside V and then you are connecting it with another path within V, the endpoint of that will be also inside V. Okay, so this P inverse of V is the union of all these things, obvious. All right, second part is, take a class tau which belongs to V omega, some member of X bar. This is an element of X bar. Suppose it belongs to V omega which I mean that way. That would mean that V omega is equal to V tau. So this is like group theory, wherein, you know, if X is in H, then it's right coset Hx will be H itself. It is of that nature. Okay. So let us see what happened. Suppose this thing here, omega, this is tau, my tau. Okay. Tau belongs to V omega, means this one, right? It is omega star omega 1 for some omega 1. Right? Suppose this is tau. Now look at V tau. V tau will be what? All those paths coming up till here, and then path is we go within V from this point. But I am taking the homotopy classes of paths. Therefore, in particular, after going here, I can come back from this path up to this point. That will be homotopic to omega 1. Therefore, V tau is contained inside omega 1, and V omega 1, V omega is contained inside V tau. So these two are equal. Okay, so this is completely trivial, but if you look at the picture, it will be better. So this will happen either some element is here when the both the classes are the same, or which just means that V omega and V tau in general are disjoint. Either they are equal or they are disjoint. If they intersect, they must be the same. This is like the coset spaces inside, coset sets inside of a group. Okay, V omega intersection V tau is non-empty would imply V omega equal to V tau. Therefore, what we have proved is P inverse of V is a disjoint union of some V omegas. Okay. So you see, this is what we wanted after all. Then I want to say that each V omega comes to V, which is obvious, by a homeomorphism, namely P restricted to V omega to V is a homeomorphism. This is what we have to verify. Okay. If V is path connected, it follows that P from V omega to V is surjective. Once a path has come inside, omega has come inside V, from there I can join it to every point inside V. So that gives you that P is surjective from V omega to V. Let us show that this is injective, and this is where we, so far we never used this fact, namely V is ambiently unconnected. So far we not, this is where the injectivity, we use that one. Okay. Having said that, I can leave it as an exercise, but now let us verify this one. Suppose P tau 1 is equal to P tau 2. Tau 1 and tau 2 are two elements in X bar. Okay, actually I should assume that they are inside V omega. Okay, where tau i's are inside V omega. That means what? Tau i is omega star omega i equal to 1 and 2. Okay, but now I am assuming that P tau 1 and P tau 2, this means that their endpoints are the same. So you can go back to this picture, modulo that these two endpoints here of omega 1 and omega 2 are the same. What does that mean? Omega 1, omega 2 inverse is a loop. Where? Inside V1. Therefore, inside X it is null homotopic. If this is null homotopic, then we know that this omega followed by omega 2 is the same thing as omega followed by omega 2 all the way omega 1 and come back to omega 1. It just means that tau 1 is homotopic to tau 2. Okay, this kind of things we have seen several times. So I repeat this. So omega 1 equal to omega 2 means they have same endpoints. I checked from pi 1 of V to pi 1 of X is trivial. So we know that omega 1 composite omega 2 inverse is null homotopy. The class is 1. Therefore, tau 1, which is omega star omega 1, is omega star omega 1. I can put omega 2 inverse star omega 2 because this is trivial. But now put the bracket this way. Omega 1 star omega 2 inverse is trivial, so this cancels out. What is left out is omega star omega 2, which is tau 2. Okay. So we have got P from V omega to V as a bijective mapping. Okay, P is already continuous. What is P? We have shown that P is an open mapping. Okay, P is also an open mapping, right? Only thing what remains is we have to show that each V omega is an open map, open set. Okay. So that is remaining. Then projection that P is a covering projection will be over, because we have to show that P inverse of V is the disjoint union of open sets, each of them coming homeomorphically onto V. Okay, so everything else is shown except V omega must be an open set. Okay, so V omega is where? V omega is in X bar. X bar is a quotient space of P. How to show something is open there? Show that V inverse of that set is open in P. Okay, this is the definition of the quotient topology. So I have to show V inverse of V omega is open in P. Take any lambda in V inverse of omega. Sorry, V inverse of V omega. Around that, I should produce an open set contained inside V inverse of omega. Right? Yes or no? For every point inside this, you should show a open set. What are open subsets? A compact open topology is what you have to show. You have to produce that. Some basic open set, namely intersection of K, I, V, I, etc. has to be found out now. So what's this? Look at this lambda, which is the map from X0 to some point inside V, right? Because it belongs to P of that, phi of that belongs to lambda V. That's the meaning. The class of lambda, phi is nothing but class of lambda, belongs to V omega, okay? So this entire curve can be covered by finitely many ambiently unconnected open sets V1, V2, Vn. The last V1, I can choose it as V itself. Okay, I can come back from that side. Start with V and then cover some other portion, some other portions. Actually, you can take a infinite covering first and then take a finite covering, because the whole thing is compact, lambda is compact, okay? And get a partition 0 less than equal to t0 less than tn, etc., 1, such that each ti is in the, you know, it's like a chain, is in the intersection. 0 to t1, t0 to t1 is inside v1, t1 to t2 is inside v2, and so on. Lambda of ti, ti plus 1 is inside vi. Okay, so cut the entire lambda and cover it, so then cut it into partition into these subintervals. If W denote the set of all paths is lambda prime at X naught, starting at X naught means that, such that lambda prime of Ti, Ti plus 1 is inside Vi, that is a basic open set. By definition, for every I, 1, 2, 3, up to n. Okay, then by definition of the compact open topology, this W is open. This W is nothing but Ti, Ti plus 1, bracket, Vi. Right? That inner product bracket symbol is there. And W is intersection of those things. Okay, so that W is an open subset of P, and lambda, to start with, lambda satisfies this property, so lambda is in W. Claim is this W is inside phi inverse of V lambda. Okay, which is same thing as taking that its homotopic class lambda belongs to V omega, V omega. The homotopic class of lambda belongs to V omega. Remember, what is V omega? V omega consists of omega star some extension, omega prime within the last V. V is one of them. V is Vn. So we have to show this homotopy property for this lambda, for all this such a lambda inside W. Okay. So here is the last picture. This was your lambda, okay, which you covered by these evenly covered open subsets V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, and this is Vn, which is equal to V. This is lambda prime, which also should satisfy that 0 to T1 or T1 to T, whatever, is concerned is a V1, and T1 to T2 is concerned is a V2, and so on. Okay. Look at T1, image of T1. Up to T1, 0 to T1, both the paths are inside V1. So join them, the endpoints here, you get a loop that is null homotopy. Join T2 and T3 by a loop, then you get a loop inside V2. That's also null homotopy. Join T3 and T4, sorry, T3. Lambda T3 and lambda omega lambda prime T3, that will be also null homotopy. This way, all that you will get is this path is homotopic to this path, composite this back, going back, composite going back, composite going back, and so on. Exactly similar to the Venkampa's theorem that we have proved right in the beginning. The proof of Venkampa's theorem, if you remember. Introducing in between paths here. Okay, so it follows that this lambda prime is homotopic to this lambda, and in particular lambda prime lambda are arbitrary sets, you know, it applies to omega also. So they are all homotopic to omega star something. Okay, so this completes the proof of that P is a covering projection. Okay. What remains? The proof of simply connectivity of X bar. So let us complete that. Connectivity follows because P is connected and is a quotient map. Okay, there is no problem. It is path connected because P is path connected and it's a quotient map. To show that X bar is simply connected, let lambda, capital lambda, from I to X bar be a loop at the constant path at X naught. Okay, you have to choose some point, base point, which comes to X naught, right? So I choose a constant path at X naught, where CX naught denotes the homotopy class of the constant loop at X naught. In order to show that this loop is null homotopic in X bar. So lambda is a loop, loop of loops, remember that. It is not an ordinary loop now. Loop taking values inside the classes of loops, classes of paths, sorry. Okay. So in order to show that this is null homotopic in X bar, by the injectivity of P check is already we have proved that it is what? It's a covering projection. Therefore, P check is a covering projection, is an injective map. So you go down to X and show that, you know, P composite lambda is null homotopic. The P check, in injective P check, suffice show that, let us write it as omega, which is P composite lambda, this is null homotopic in X. Okay, so we are using the partly proved statements to prove further things here. This is what it is. Okay, so now what is this lambda? Lambda is I prove X bar. We have come here. Okay, this is a loop in CX naught has to be used. All right, so let capital omega from I to P be defined by omega TS equal to omega TS, which we have considered for contractibility of P. Okay. So define now the path defined by this one is such that if you take the endpoint of this one, this will be omega. Here, what I have taken is the same omega I have taken. Okay, the endpoint of this for each you take, it will be s is equal to 1, omega t will come. So the whole path will come. S equal to 1, I have to put this omega t. So it's a path now. The endpoint path is a path. This was a loop of paths. Okay. Therefore, p composite, phi composite omega is nothing but omega. This is p composite phi, remember. E is by definition, p is by definition such that p composite phi is E. So p of phi composite omega is omega. Thus, we have two lifts. One is capital lambda, another is phi composite omega of this omega in x bar. There are two lifts. Moreover, phi omega of 0 is the constant loop Cx0, which is lambda of 0. Therefore, by unique path lifting property of the covering projection P, it follows that this lambda is nothing but phi composite omega. This path we have. So we took lambda, came to X under P, then we identifying what is this original lambda. It is phi of omega. This omega is now all the way inside P. Okay. So you see, we have used the property that arbitrary paths inside X can be lifted to the P very easily. Okay. And when we quotient it out, the lifting property is still retained by covering projections. This is what is happening. So here we have used the lift. So this omega has been lifted to this capital omega, and that under quotient map, it becomes this lambda. Therefore, phi of omega 1, which is lambda 1, which is Cx0, which means that omega equal to omega of 1 is null homotopy. Look at omega 1, what is when t equal to 1, that path. Okay. So that omega, that's omega 1, right? When you put s equal to 1. So this is null homotopy is what it means. Right? Phi is what? Phi is the homotopy class of this one. Omega 1 is a loop. Right? This is Cx0. Right? So this class is same thing as Cx0, means omega 1 is null homotopy. But omega 1 is nothing but omega. Okay? So, most of it is like tautology. Actually, several constructions in mathematics, when you have in a blank where to go for, is tautological. Right in the beginning of, construction of real numbers out of Cauchy sequences of rational numbers. You want every Cauchy sequence to be convergent. What did you do? You took equivalence classes of Cauchy sequences and declared them as real numbers. Over. Now, Cauchy sequence of Cauchy sequences convergent is what you have to show. So, this proof is similar to that. You want all kinds of lifts of paths inside a simply connected covering. So, you declare the covering itself to be set of all paths, but that is too much, so you have to do equivalence classes. So, it is in simplistic language, this is, I could have taken the example of metric completion of a metric space, or construction of real numbers, and this is similar to that. Okay, so let us stop here. Let us come back to other things in the next session. Thank you.